Hello and welcome. So you're interested in how to create stairs parametrically in Autodesk Inventor? No problem. With SolidSteel Parametric, it's easy, even if the sketch you see here looks complicated. This sketch is from another project that ended up looking like this. We're just using two sketch lines from it, as we'll see. So let's get started. We'll use the stair tool, of course. And as I promised a second ago, we'll just select the bottom start line and the top end line and get an instant preview. The staircase will probably look different from what you imagined, but don't worry. The great thing about parametric stair design is that you can define everything you need from this simple basic shape. For example, we can define the treads here, using libraries with international standards, and we can set the profiles of the stringers up here. Okay, those were relatively predictable changes. SolidSteel Parametric offers some really exciting customization features when we click on Configure. Here in the Configuration menu, we always see an overview of all the calculated values on the left side, and we can change parameters on the right side. Here in the first tab, for example, we can create a horizontal offset to ensure that there is enough distance to the future columns. In the second tab, we can add extensions both at the top and at the bottom. So we can automatically add landings to the staircase and configure the staircase directly here as we need it. In the third tab, for example, we define the floor offsets. If we know that the gratings on the landings are 20 millimeters thick, we can enter this dimension both at the top and at the bottom and see in the preview that the steps move. This way, the rise heights are always the same from the finished floor to the finished floor of the landings. Additional steps at the top or bottom can also be easily added in this tab. We can also move the steps horizontally, which is possible here in the fourth tab, for example 50 millimeters forward. This can be useful depending on the profile size selected or the stair's angle of inclination. In our example, however, it makes no sense, so I will delete my entry. Okay, now we can confirm our entries. Before doing so, I would like to point out the red numbers in the summary that you have probably already noticed. These numbers indicate that you have exceeded or fallen short of self-defined criteria. As delivered, the criteria is based on a German standard, and according to this standard the step would be a little too short, and therefore also the increment. However, the deviations are minimal and okay for an industrial staircase. Now we confirm. We are now in the last step before placing the staircase. We only have to define the bolting between the tread and the stringer, which we do with the part selection. The definition is made here by selecting a standard and a bolt diameter. And we can also add default mountings consisting of two washers and a nut with a single click. Okay, now we have defined the staircase including all the details, and all we have to do is click on execute to finally insert the whole staircase. This takes a few moments while, for example, the miter cuts, holes in the profiles and welded assemblies are created. The steps of course are placed and all the holes including the bolted connections are added. Finished. Here is our complete and fully detailed staircase. If you want to try it for yourself, be sure to get the express version of SolidSteel Parametric for Autodesk Inventor. This version is free, but limited to 10 connections, which is just enough for one staircase. Did you like the video? Share it with a like and subscribe so you don't miss any new videos on steel design with Autodesk Inventor. See you next time.